Hello. Today I'd like to explore the difference between knowledge and wisdom. And, you know, this is something I come across a lot, and it's very easy for someone like me to be misunderstood. I often am. Particularly, you know, when people who don't really have a spiritual kind of impulse inside them, or not one that they've discovered yet, and then they look in on what I'm doing here with these teachings, and they kind of think, well, what is it? I don't understand. What's it founded on? You know, it seems so obscure, or, you know, non-scientific, and those kind of things. And the reason is that I'm in the business of wisdom. The Gene Keys is about wisdom. And that's very different from knowledge. The rest of the world, mostly the mainstream, is involved in knowledge. And knowledge is like a sword, and wisdom is like a cup, you know, or a chalice. And so knowledge goes after what it wants, and it's proactive in that way. And it uses the mind, and it cuts things open to understand them. And it's endlessly exploring. It's endlessly hungry, knowledge, in order to understand things and put things together and make sense of things. And it's the basis of science. It's the basis of anything that is to do with the mind, anything that is mental in nature, that is involving understanding life and the things around us, is knowledge based. And so we take that as, you know, we don't even think about it, because we live in a knowledge society, a knowledge planet. But then there's wisdom, and wisdom's very different, because wisdom's the chalice. You know, it doesn't go out there and slay and understand, to try and like cut things open and understand them. It doesn't. Wisdom comes through revelation. You know, wisdom comes through revelation. And revelation is something that opens up inside us. And then things are revealed from the inside out, which involves waiting, which involves imbibing. You know, wisdom is something you imbibe, like the chalice, you drink of it. And to drink of it, you have to taste things. You have to listen to life. You have to empathize. You have to be silent. You have to switch off the mind. And then it comes through the whole being. Wisdom arrives and arises within us. It flowers within us. So revelation is very, very different from, you know, the procuring of knowledge, the seeking that is involved in the world of knowledge. And wisdom comes, and it doesn't have the same taste as knowledge at all. Because when wisdom, it's an ever flowing source of, you know, nourishment for the soul, because wisdom doesn't answer all the questions, but it sort of stops the questions, you know. And it doesn't mean that they go away forever, because that's the questing part of the mind, but it brings the balance that the questions are not as important as the wisdom, because the wisdom is what we really need in order to make clear decisions, so, you know, so that we can live a fulfilling life. So you can have wisdom without knowledge, and you could have knowledge without wisdom. The best is to have a balance of both. But there's a natural hierarchy. You know, if you put knowledge before wisdom, it's like putting a cart before the horse. It's just never going to work. You won't get anywhere. The wisdom has to come first. It has to be the source, because it dives into the source. All knowledge comes from the source. So wisdom bypasses the mind altogether and goes straight to the source of being, which is something more mysterious. You know, it's something that is more to do with silence. It's something that is more to do with mystery. You know, wisdom thrives on mystery. You know, that there is no end to the mystery of wisdom. There's nothing in it that wishes to solve the mystery, because wisdom knows that the mystery cannot be solved by seeking with the mind. It can only be imbibed and embodied until we become the mystery. And when you become the mystery, then everything in your life comes into balance. You know, you then have lucidity in your mind, because you're drawing from all elements of the cosmos, you know, and you are fed and nourished by something that goes far beyond knowledge. So correct understanding of these two areas, of these two whole spheres of being and how different they are, is really important. You know, when you look out in the world and you see people that are engaged only in the path of knowledge, then you know that they're going to always be unhappy somewhere deep, unfulfilled. Some, they may have moments of happiness like we all do. But until you can tap the source of wisdom, you can never slake that thirst that the mind has. You can never feel the engagement of that spirit inside you, that eternal spirit, because wisdom is infinite and knowledge cannot encompass infinity. It cannot possibly ever crack the chestnut of mystery that is infinity. It's not of the same dimension. So if it's not of the same dimension, there's no way it can understand it. You know, really, it can penetrate some of the workings of the universe, and that can be of incredible help for us as a species, to help us solve real life problems, medical problems, problems of health, problems of, you know, of all kinds of things in our societies that can help us, live healthier, happier lives. But ultimately, until we come to this true source of wisdom inside us, it all is for nothing, you know, unless you can tap the universal spirit of the eternal. It's all for nothing, you know, because we're just rats in mazes, chasing our own tails, hungry, endlessly hungry, endlessly trying to solve problems that are really rooted in a much deeper place inside us, in the divine feminine, this chalice. So have both. Carry the sword of knowledge, but also drink first from the chalice of wisdom, which is your body, your being, your spirit. Something beyond words, something felt deep in the silence of the night, of the silence between words, between the dreams of this world, the hopes and wishes and yearnings that humans have. Underneath all of that lies wisdom. So if you're interested in finding out more about what wisdom is and how you can tap it, you might want to begin with this little book called The Art of Contemplation. And I didn't know I was going to say that at the end, but as a practical thing, like, this is a book that, and a technique and an art that shows you how to drink from the chalice of wisdom. And then everything else comes into its own balance on its own. So knowledge and wisdom, sword and chalice, carry them both in equal, with equal vigor and love and appreciation.